So this is a thermal conductivity of metal rod experiment. This experiment is used to determine the thermal conductivity of various materials. Here we are conducting the experiment for copper to determine its thermal conductivity. We all know thermal conductivity is a material property. It is defined as the amount of heat conducted per unit area if the temperature difference is unity. That means for 1 degree change, what is the amount of heat which is conducted? So which is given by Fourier's law. So here this is a setup. In this setup we are having the metal rod which is concealed with insulators. Now 5 different places we have placed the thermocouples to get the readings of the temperatures. Now the procedure is, first we go to switch on the mains, switch on the console, and then a dimmer stat. So the dimmer stat heat is supplied, suppose say 60 volts. So the corresponding amperes is 0.06. So you can see here, so the heat supplied is 60 into 0.06. So that is the heat supplied. Then from the switch indicator, we can just find the various temperatures T1, T2, T3, T4 and T5. So once the temperature is noted down, we'll go to the tabular column. In the tabular column, this is a voltage, current. So voltage is 60 in our case, current is 0.06, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, the temperature is noted. Now Q is, that is a heat, voltage into current. Okay, how to find thermal conductivity? It's very simple. We know the Fourier law of conduction. What is the Fourier law of conduction? Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx. Yes, here. So from there, from Fourier law, K is equal to minus Q divided by area dT by dx. Q is voltage into current, area of the metal rod is, that is a dia and length is given, that is observation, please calculate the area. dT by dx is obtained from the graph. You can clearly observe near the source, that is near the heater. This is a heater source, near the heater, akadala sir, sorry. Near the heater source, we can see the temperature is high, and far away from the heater, the temperature is going to decrease. So we are going to get the temperature profile in a decreasing trend. So dT by dx is negative in this case. We find the slope dT by dx which is negative, and this is negative, and we are also having a negative sign already. So it will get tallied and we get a positive value. So the range is around 300 to 400 for the thermal conductivity of copper.